Hello, today I'm going to show you how to draw this strawberry. First open a new document, then press the letter R to show the ruler, and press the Ctrl and quotation mark keys to show the grid. If you would like to use the same grid setting as mine, either go to Edit, Preferences and choose Guides and Grid, or press the Ctrl and K buttons on your keyboard. Choose Guides and Grid. Set the grid line to every 140 pixels and the subdivisions to 6. Click OK. Here is the color group I will be using for this project. Now let's change the stroke to none and the fill to light red. Next, click on the rectangle tool, hold and select the polygon tool. Single click on the artboard and type 3 for the sides and 450 for the radius. Click OK. Let's rotate this triangle by 180 degrees. Using the selection tool, hover over one of the corners until you see a double-sided arrow. Click, hold and drag. While you are dragging your mouse, press the Shift key as well. This will rotate an object by 45 degree increments. Next, we will round the corners. Go to Effect, Stylize and choose Round Corners. Set the radius to 260. In the next few steps, we'll create speckles and space them equally. First, we'll make these guides to help us with our drawing. Select the Polygon tool again. Single click on the artboard and change the radius to 170. Swap the fill and the stroke, change its color, and rotate it by 180 degrees. Let's move it over here. Now select both shapes, open the Align window, make sure Align to Selection is checked, and choose Horizontal and Vertical Align Center. Select the small triangle and let's duplicate it. Press the Ctrl and C buttons on your keyboard to copy it and Ctrl F to paste it in front. Then rotate it by 180 degrees. In the next several steps, we will create this speckle. First, swap the fill and the stroke, zoom in and select the rectangle tool. Now draw a small rectangle and rotate it by 45 degrees. Next, go to Effect, Distort and Transform and choose Pucker and Bloat. Check the preview box so you can better see what we are doing and move the slider to the left to about negative 28. Let's change the color of this shape to white, move it over here and place the center of it on this intersection. Now duplicate this shape. Place it over the next intersection and press the Ctrl and D keys on your keyboard to make one more copy. Next, select these two shapes and copy them over here. Finally, select just one shape, make one more copy and place it over this intersection. Now select the blue triangles and press the Delete key on your keyboard. We won't need them anymore. In the next few steps, we will create shading that will look like this. First, select everything, go to Object and choose Expand Appearance. Let's zoom in and place a guideline right through the center of this shape. To do that, click on the ruler, hold and drag. Now we will cut this shape in half. First, select the knife tool. It is hidden under the eraser tool. Now a very important part. Before you do anything, first press and hold down the Alt key. Then click on this guide just above the red shape, hold and drag. While you are dragging your mouse, press the Shift key as well to constrain it. And click below the shape to finish the cut. Now select the red shape on the left and let's apply a darker red to it. Select the white shapes on the left and apply pink. Let's zoom out, select everything and press the Ctrl and G keys on your keyboard to group everything together. This will prevent it from shifting. In the next several steps, we will create leaves and a stem. First, select the rectangle tool, change the color to green, zoom in and draw a small rectangle. Next, press the letter V to select it and go to the Shear tool. It is hidden under the Scale tool. Now, double-click on the Shear tool and set the shear angle to 45 degrees. Click OK. Next, we'll copy and reflect this shape to the top. First select it and then press the letter O for the Reflect tool or select it from the toolbar panel. Now press and hold down the Alt key and click on this anchor point to set the reflection point. Change the axis to horizontal and click Copy. Change the color of this new shape to light green. Now select both shapes, rotate it by 45 degrees, and we will copy and reflect them to the right. Let's place them over here, select both shapes, and press the letter O for the Reflect tool. Now set the reflection point in the middle of this graph square. This time change the axis to vertical and click Copy. Now we need to draw a stem. Select the rectangle tool and draw a long and narrow rectangle that will fit between these two leaves. Select all green shapes and group them together. Now place it on top of the strawberry. Then either press the Ctrl and left bracket keys on your keyboard to send it to the back, or right click with your mouse, choose Arrange and send to back. Finally, we will align everything to the artboard. Select everything, group it together, hide the grid, guides, select everything, make sure the align to artboard is checked, and choose horizontal and vertical align center. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.